We are today here for another session of Coffee at CIE, and we are presenting today the music of Brazilian Carnival. Welcome everyone, and bem-vindos for our friends in Brazil. We've been sound checking for a little bit, so everybody's here. Just a quick word on Coffee at CIE. That is a monthly series offered by Loyola's Center for International Education. And we have started in 2019 highlighting international cultural topics. And we love to feature members of our Loyola community, as we will do today. My name is Dietmar Dittrich, and I'm the assistant director at CIE, and I'll be hosting today. For the January Carnival edition of Coffee at CIE, we wanted to say a few words on Carnival. For people in New Orleans, not much needs to be said, but we wanted to highlight that there are many distinct expressions of Carnival, like worldwide. They're very different types in Europe, in Latin America, in the US. And so a lot of features could be like music, dance, costumes, parades of very different types. And there's foods like king cake in New Orleans. There are throws. I have a little throw here. It's probably too small to see. This is a Zulu coconut fish. So there are all kinds of things that you can experience during Carnival. And then there's also like sometimes there's political satire, like crew de vue in New Orleans. The crew, they have a little of that. And there are even Carnival events that are focusing on silence that can be very solemn in Switzerland, for example. Now in New Orleans in Brazil, what we're focusing on today, there are world famous Carnival celebrations, and they focus on exuberant musical expression. And Loyola has a famous College of Music and Media, and it's one of our crown jewels, like among the programs we offer. And it attracts a lot of talented teachers, performers, and especially students. One of our students is Giulia Barreto from São Paulo in Brazil. And she has been with us since 2019. She's a jazz studies major. Before joining Loyola, she studied guitar and voice at São Paulo State Conservatory Tangerine. And she has a specific focus on exploring new dimensions of vocal improvisation. She's been leading her own trios, playing jazz and Brazilian music since 2017. And she even received a scholarship to attend a jazz festival in Italy, the Arcevia Jazz Festival. Also, she's been working with CIE before at Loyola. In 2019, she was performing at the Loyola International Country Fair with Carmelo Munoz. Today, Julia's trio features her on guitar and vocals. She has Naira Jane in the background on percussion. Hello, Naira. And then Laumart on flute. And hey, Lau. And so Giulia, I'll hand it over to Giulia now, live from São Paulo. She will tell us more about her band and about Brazilian music. Thank you.
Thank you for your introduction, Dietmar. It's lovely to be here. I'm very happy to be hosting this presentation with you and to talk about a topic that we all love, Carnival. I believe everyone here really enjoys this celebration, either if you experience in Germany, in New Orleans, or in any other countries that celebrate Carnival. It's a very important tradition. I would say especially for us who live in either Brazil or New Orleans, it's very important. So first of all, I would like to give a little introduction and say a few things about the people playing here. So as Dietmar said, I'm Giulia Barreto. This is Laudisvan Marques, also known as Lau Marques. And this is Naira Jaini. And I'm gonna talk about a few of their experiences because they're both very talented musicians who related to Carnival in different ways. They had different experiences related to Carnival, working on Carnival, playing on marching bands, parades, and playing other kinds of Brazilian music. So it's nice to talk a little bit about them. So Naira was born in the city of Louveira in São Paulo. It's in the countryside, it's a small town, and it's really lovely. And besides being a percussionist, she's an actress, a cultural producer, and she began her studies at Bamalo, which is Loveda's official marching band. So they have a really important social work that teaches young children to play and develops a really nice job. We can also show you a little bit of Bamalu's experience. So later on, she began playing at Bamalu. Then she played, continued playing in this marching band where she later worked as a music instructor. In 2016, she joined MSP Tom Jobim, the São Paulo State Music Conservatory, which I also attended. She studied percussion, and we used to play together in one of the ensembles and have a few lessons together. And when you study popular percussion, it's the name of the course here in Brazil, you study folk music from Latin America, jazz, and lots of traditional Brazilian rhythms. And the same applies to when you're studying voice or guitar. She recently completed her acting certificate program at ETEC School of Arts. And Naida, as I said, she's a cultural producer who was in charge of several cultural events at MSP and Loveda, her hometown. She founded Coletivo Abertamente, which is an organization that supports independent artists in her hometown. So I'm very glad to be here playing with her. Yay. Okay.
Thank you.
Nice. All right. So Lau Marques is a musician and a teacher with over 20 years of experience in the field. His specific skills include arrangement, composition, conducting choir and orchestra, flute, saxophone, guitar, and Cavaco. He was personally my professor, and I learned a lot of what I know today from Lau Marques, which is a very important person in my life who helped me decide whether I wanted to be a musician or not. So I'm really glad and honored to be playing with him today. He's originally from São Paulo, and Lau claims that one of his most valuable experiences as a musician was the year he spent abroad, in the northeast of the country, learning Brazilian rhythms and playing with people from the northeast, which are the main influences of Brazilian music, where many of the rhythms were originated. And in the northeast of the country, we have the widest Black population outside Africa in Brazil. So we really have a lot of Black people and a Black culture that was really important to spread those rhythms and to create many of the characteristics that we know today of Brazilian music. So this is an important aspect. He translated part of his life and career into two different original albums, Essencial Lado A and Essencial Lado B, in which he combines some of those important rhythms from the Northeast, which include Baião, Choro, Maracatu, jazz, and also classical influences that he had and in his Brazilian instrumental music. Okay, so I tried to be brief. I know I failed a little bit, but we're gonna start talking a little bit about Carnival. I don't wanna talk too much at this point because we're also planning on playing a little bit for you. We prepared a few things. But first, I wanted to ask if anybody wants to interact and say, why is Carnival important to you? And how do you relate to Carnival? Just maybe a brief phrase or...
Maybe I can go first. So this is Dietmar, I'm from Germany. So in Germany, in the north, there is no carnival at all. And so for me, it's always been like something to very important that I wanted to explore. And being in New Orleans, it has become like a very important part during carnival season that we have costumes on Mardi Gras Day. We costume, and then there's a lot of king cake that we pass around. And those are very New Orleans traditions. So for me, my wife and I, we've totally embraced that. So it's very important. So that part, and it's good that Loyola has vacation during Mardi Gras.
Great.
That's my Mardi Gras impression.
Thank you, Dietmar. Well, if anybody wants to share their experiences, but for me, Carnival, it's very important because I'm aware that it's a major part of Brazilian culture. It's not all we have, of course, but like the music that we have and the rhythms that we play. And I believe part of our personality as Brazilians is also attached to carnival. And for some people, such as Naira, it's even more important because there are lots of us who grow up and have a particular, we call it Escola de Samba, which is a particular club. It's like a samba school that plays, and every year they prepare original material, including a song for, actually a few songs for each of the schools. They prepare the costumes for a whole year. And I know the same preparation also happens during Mardi Gras, which is also really important. So what happens here is that we have a competition in Brazil. So every carnival, those schools, they have sorts of presentations. So the people who prepare themselves the whole year, they go, and during that night, all the work they attributed to this specific samba school happens. And it's really nice to see all those colors and all the music and everything that goes on those specific dates. But for what I experienced, once I was in 2017, I danced and also performed with Colorado do Brás, which is a small samba school here in São Paulo. And it was a marvelous experience, I believe, for some people who have been in floats and also dancing along or either playing in marching bands. I believe you can all share that energy that goes around when you're just with all those people and playing the same music and having all these vibrancy that makes us even more unite and all together. So I said specifically that Naira has even a more profound connection to carnival because she's one of those people who grew up in a specific samba school, and she would always like rehearse with them. And you see small children like starting to grab the instruments, such as the pandeiro. Can you show them the pandeiro? Right, or the surdo. And you have many other small percussion instruments that for most people are the way you begin to participate in that specific celebration, because everyone can grab an agogô. Right, you have an agogô here, right? Okay. So those are some of the instruments that we use. And from a very small age, from a very young age, people start playing them. So you really internalize those rhythms and you really internalize the meaning of the celebration. So sometimes you see people that don't have that much training, that much musical training, who have an immense and amazing ability playing those instruments. And it's not at all because they haven't studied, because they're just born really talented, but it's because the essence of that music and the essence of those rhythms, it's part of their family, it's part of their culture, and it's part of who they are. So I believe that's how some people relate to carnival here. And that might also, as I saw, I only experienced one Mardi Gras, but it was really exciting and beautiful to see. I saw a lot of the same energy there, how people get excited when they're playing their instruments, when they're playing percussion. Some of the grooves and some of the rhythms that I heard are also pretty similar from what we have here. Of course, we have all the variations, and we wouldn't be able to explain today all of those different rhythms and all those genres. But what we can relate here is that in New Orleans, you have a melting pot of different cultures, and you have French culture, Spanish culture, and you have Creole, and you have all these African influences that completely shaped the culture of New Orleans and the rhythms that we hear. So the same thing happened here. Of course, they're not all the same influences, but as I told you, we have a huge African community, and that shaped a lot of rhythms that we saw here. Of course, we are in Latin America, and we have all those neighbor countries, which are like right over there, and we share some of the cultures. We have samba from Argentina, samba from Brazil, and all those different things that have their specific characteristics. Some will be melodic, some will be in the accents, but sometimes when you hear them, you can really say, okay, like I feel like I heard it before. But it's because we all kind of share those same influences. And also when we talk about the carnival dates, how it's organized, how the festivities are organized, it's pretty much the same. When you consider New Orleans and when you consider Brazilian Carnival, it happens on the same days because it's carnival. It originates from like Christian culture as well. And it happens 47 days before Easter, right? And it always ends on a Tuesday, if I'm not mistaken. And the Tuesday that precedes the Ash Wednesdays. And the same thing happens here. We also have those names. We don't call it Fat Tuesday, for example. But we celebrate it in a very similar way. When we talk about like the specific periods that we start celebrating, of course, people are really excited about Carnival and also about Mardi Gras. So some of those floats and some of those parades, they happen even before because people can't even wait. So it begins in January. And in the beginning of January, you already see lots of parades, and they all have different themes. Some have a very particular meaning. Some are activist parades, which is really nice. And we see that growing in Brazil and also in other parts of the world, as well as New Orleans. I was talking to Dietmar about Honk, which is a festival that happens in the United States and all over the world that gathers marching bands and activist bands. I believe some of you might know it. And I think it's really, really nice and interesting to have that because some of the traditions that we share in Brazil, and I noticed as well in New Orleans, part of that tradition also carries part of racism, which is a concerning subject. And some of the songs that are played here in Brazil are not played anymore because they would have racist lyrics. And through as society evolves, we have to change some traditions and realize, okay, that's not a good thing, as well as like what happened with the parades in New Orleans in 1992, if I'm not mistaken. They were prohibited to like have segregated crews with like who would prohibit Black people from participating. I think Rex is one of them, if I'm not sure. Some of the clubs and some of the parades even stopped happening because they didn't want to be didn't want to happen all together and include everyone. Dietmar, do you have any words in that? I feel like you look like you want to say something.
That's totally correct. Like Momus and Comus were very famous crews, and so they only have their balls now because they're not parading anymore. They didn't want to integrate. And for example, Zulu, the coconut that I showed, it's a mainly African-American parade, but they also have non-African Americans in the parade. And you have a good example for integration where people think, oh, this is mainly African American, but it's actually open to others.
That's really nice. Yeah. What? I'm sorry.
No,
there's a little bit of delay.
No, okay. Tadaji, you're right.
Okay, thank you. And you can also, I'm talking about Mardi Gras in New Orleans, but of course this is not my own culture and it's not my own experience. So if anyone wants to add anything that you think consider important or would like to share, I would be very happy to learn from you, because I'm still beginning to understand Mardi Gras, but I think after you experience it many times, you can really relate to it and fully grasp it. And the same happens with Brazilian Carnival.
We're looking forward to having you back in New Orleans, and then you'll experience even more Mardi Gras editions.
No, I really want that to happen. You can imagine.
And we're very excited to hear the songs you prepared for us. Like, we already listened to a little bit during the sound check, and it sounded really great. If you maybe want to introduce the first song, that'd be...
Okay, all right. O meu lugar é caminho de Ogum e Ansã. Lá tem samba até de manhã e uma ginga em cada andar. O meu lugar é cercado de luta e suor, esperança num mundo melhor e cerveja pra comemorar. O meu lugar tem seus mitos e seres de luz, é bem perto de Oswaldo Cruz, Cascadura, Paz, Lobo, Irajá. O meu lugar é sorriso, é paz e prazer, o seu nome é doce dizer, Madureira. Ia, la, ia. Madureira, la, la, ia. O meu lugar é caminho de Ogum e Ansã, lá tem samba até de manhã, uma ginga em cada andar. O meu lugar é cercado de luta e suor, esperança num mundo melhor e cerveja pra comemorar. O meu lugar tem seus mitos e seres de luz, é bem perto de Oswaldo Cruz, Cascadura, Paz, Lobo, Irajá. Sorriso é paz e prazer, o seu nome é doce dizer, Madureira. Ia, la, ia. Madureira, la, la, ia. Ai, que lugar, a saudade me faz relembrar dos amores que eu tive por lá. É difícil esquecer doce lugar, que é eterno no meu coração, aos poetas traz inspiração pra tocar e escrever. Ai, meu lugar, quem não viu tia Eulália dançar, Bó Maria ao terreiro benzer, e ainda tem jongo à luz do luar. Ai, meu lugar, tem mil coisas pra gente dizer, difícil é saber terminar. Madureira, ia, la, ia. Madureira, ia, la, ia. Madureira, em cada esquina um pagode, um bar. Em Madureira, Império e Portela também são de lá. Em Madureira, e no Pecadão você pode comprar, por uma pechincha você vai levar, um dengo, um sonho pra quem quer sonhar. Em Madureira, e uma pezinha até posso fazer, pelo que cantos eu vou te encontrar, pelos sete cantos eu vou te encontrar. Em Madureira, ia.
That was great. Obrigadinho.
Thank you. It's really fun to see the little like hands clapping on Zoom.
Zoom makes it all possible, like little reactions.
Yeah, it's nice. I would much rather be there playing with you, but it's really cool that we found a way to connect and to share through Zoom. And even through such weird times, we could share a little bit of music. Okay. So this song was Meu Lugar by Mauro Diniz. And it's just a classic. It's a samba classic. It's not like a particular song that belongs to Carnival, but anyone who likes samba and really enjoys its song, I think it's a beautiful song with nice harmonies and a beautiful melody. And it's really great. Okay. That's him. Nice. All right. So here we try to show you different rhythms and not stuck onto one little thing. The potpourri that we first played, it has a particular rhythm on the guitar. You could hear like so and it's a very exactly just that. Play a little bit for them. So that's the constant accents that you're going to hear. Many of them relate throughout different rhythms. But now what we played was a partido alto, which is also a different, like a subgenre from samba. Play a little bit of partido alto on pandeiro, just for them to, yeah. Could you hear that? Is it too loud? So you have different accents and different beats. I don't know how you hear it. Maybe you can hear because sometimes Zoom just like shuts some sounds.
It was good. Sometimes it cuts out a little bit, but I think we could hear one segment as well.
Okay. Okay. I'm glad. So now we're going to play samba rock, what we like to call. So yeah, exactly. So it's a different group. It mixes a little bit of, as it said, like rock and other influences. This song is País Tropical by Jorge Benjor. I'm also going to write it here. I'm sorry you can't see it right now. But he was also a very important figure for the image of Brazilian music outside Brazil and also for different sounds to be integrated into Brazilian music. Because I'm pretty sure many of you are very familiar with Bossa Nova, for example. And what you're gonna hear now, it's really different from that. And when Brazilian music incorporated guitar and electric sounds, and also influences from rhythms all over the world and from rock music and from lots of that, then Tropicália was born, which is a very important musical movement that happened in Brazil in the mid-60s, in the mid-70s. And it's great. It's a result from that. Some of you might know Mais Que Nada, which is another song from Jorge Benjor. Mais que nada, sai da minha frente que eu quero passar. It's not the one we're going to play.
You played at the country fair.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. I played a recording to Juan, like one of our other Brazilian students who's from Florianópolis. And he was like, oh, I'm clásico. Like, I think most people. Nike had a commercial in the 90s. They used it with a Brazilian soccer team, for the national team.
That's really cool. That's nice. I saw that like some people, when I played it at a country fair, some people would really like sing along and like
start moving,
not all the lyrics and start moving. So it's nice. It was when Sérgio Mendes brought like some of Brazilian music to the US and all that. So let's play, enough of me talking. Okay. All right. Okay. Right. Moro num país tropical, abençoado por Deus
que bonito por natureza. Em fevereiro tem carnaval, tem um fusco e um violão. Sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Sam baby, sou um menino de mentalidade mediana. Mas mesmo assim na minha casa todos meus camaradinhos, meus amigos me respeitam. E essa é a razão da alegria, da harmonia e simpatia. Eu moro num país tropical, abençoado por Deus e bonito por natureza. Em fevereiro tem carnaval. Eu tenho um fusca e um violão. Sou flamengo, tenho uma nega chamada Tereza. Sam baby, posso não ser um band líder, pois é. Mas lá minha casa, meus amigos, meus camaradinhas me respeitam. E eu sou feliz, muito feliz, comigo mesmo. Eu moro no país tropical, abençoado por Deus, que bonito por natureza.
Que beleza!
Em fevereiro, tem carnaval. Eu tenho um fusca e um violão. Sou flamengo, tenho uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu moro num parque tropical, abençoar por Deus, que bonito por natureza. Em fevereiro tem carnaval. Eu tenho um fui e um viô. Sou flamengo, tenho uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu moro num país tropical, abençoado por Deus, que bonito por natureza. Em fevereiro tem carnaval. Tem um fusca e um violão. Sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Sou flamengo e tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza. Eu sou flamengo. Fafá. Sou flamengo. Sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tere. Sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tere. Sou flamengo, tem uma nega chamada Tereza.
Very cool. More emojis, more reactions.
Cool. Yeah. You knew the song already, right, Dietmar?
Yeah, I think Alexis too. He was like moving along. Yeah. So it,
really cool.
Yeah, place to be calm. I like Georgie Ben a lot. And
me too.
Yeah, one of the great.
That's great. And I was really excited to hear that Alexis plays Brazilian music as well and that he's a trumpet player. So when we were doing the sound check, we were already planning to play together eventually at some point. And hopefully.
I know, seeing all of you play and seeing you like so happy together makes me really miss playing with other people. So hopefully I can do that soon.
Yeah, hopefully. It will happen for sure. But what kinds of, did you play any of those songs that we played now? Or like, were you with the band that you played Brazilian music, did you play any of those rhythms? What did you play?
Yeah, we didn't play any of those songs specifically. The band that I played in did a lot of Brazilian rhythms like maracatu, samba, and played some more Western melodies over them. And we really did a lot of like genre blending. Like we played some, I don't know if you're familiar with like Fela Kuti. So we performed
He teaches at MSP.
Oh, wow. So yeah, we played some Fela Kuti like melodies over maracatu rhythms and samba rhythms. So that was a lot of fun.
That's awesome. I really want to hear that at some point.
Yeah, that's kind of like, I mean, kind of what you were saying about genre blending and like blending all the different cultures in New Orleans. I think that that group was really representative of that, pulling in different influences from Africa, from Brazil, kind of things that makes New Orleans what it is. Seems like you all have kind of a similar blending of music going on there too.
Exactly. Okay, so let's move to the next song. Just a second. So Lau is saying, so maracatu, it was originated specifically in the region that his family comes from. Recife, which is also in the northeast of the country. Foi em Recife que você passou ano quando você estava estudando? And it was exactly where he stayed when he was learning. So he spent years to actually learn maracatu and all those different rhythms. And it's actually part of essencial. Is it in lado A or lado B?
Maracaju.
Okay, so he has a song which is called Maracaju. It's actually like a little pun, like a wordplay with maracatu and Joe, which is like me in Spanish and all that, because it's a maracatu song that has many other influences, and it's an instrumental song. So it's maracatu with Cuban tumbao. I'm not very familiar with that. Maybe Lau could talk a little bit more about this. Not now. And at some other point, if you want, you can also email us. We're going to leave our email. And if you want to listen to Lau's album, it's really great to grab a little bit, to grasp a little bit of what we're talking about, different rhythms and how they blend all together. It's really what your album is about, right? Okay, so let's move to the next one. Baianidade na Go. Deixa eu só colocar aqui para não danar com a letra. Que a harmonia do solo você falou que não estava rolando. Just a second, just a little thing.
Tem que ler exatamente o que está aí, senão você me mata. Você fez maior essa harmonia, tá?
Tá, mas aqui não é maior? Tipo, sol, ré, sol, ré.
Você alongou a harmonia. É exatamente o que está ali. Você tocou com alguns compassos maiores, você tocou vezes a mais. Tenta seguir direitinho.
Tá, beleza.
Eu.
Ok.
Eu, Laia, eu, Laia, eu. Já pintou verão, calor no coração, a festa vai começar. Carnaval na Bahia, oitava maravilha, eternos todos. Na paz eu sou Tietê, Natal, Raul, Farol a brilhar. Carnaval na Bahia, oitava maravilha, eu nunca irei te deixar. Festejar. carnaval na Bahia. Oitava maravilha, eu nunca irei te deixar. Baianidade na go, oi, oi, oi. E eu queria que essa fantasia fosse eterna. Quem sabe um dia a paz vence a guerra. Em viver será um top festejar. Laia. Baianidade na go, oi, oi, oi. Eu queria que essa fantasia fosse eterna. Quem sabe um dia a paz vence a guerra e viver será só festejar.
Great. That was perfect. So we're running like we're already late in the show. So we probably have time for one more song, if that's okay. What do you have in mind,
Julia? So we could play Frevo Mulher. But also, if you want, we can like end now. And if anybody has any questions, because I know I talked a lot, and maybe there's some questions, so we could end now and maybe respond to some of the questions you might have.
I think maybe we'll show the email for CIE. So if people have questions, we can put them in touch with you.
And okay.
It might be nice to have one more song. That's me. Like Alexis okay. also nods. So.
Okay, great.
And I think Frevo Mulher, it sounds really cool. I saw the clip and that's Nordestino, right?
Yeah, exactly. Nordestino. Cool. So that's the word for a person who comes from the northeast of the country. And cool. Dietmar always impresses me with how much he knows about like Portuguese and Brazilian culture. It's really nice. Okay, so let's do Frevo Mulher. So Frevo also, I was saying, Frevo also comes from Recife, that specific place.
Okay.
Oh, I wish we had time to show you some of the clips, but of course we don't. But the dance of Frevo is really interesting, and people are like, they dance with little like umbrellas. They are really colorful, and it's super hard. It's really hard. I don't have the knees to do that, but it's impressive. So I might share some links later on for you to look that up. It's beautiful. It's really nice.
Cool.
Okay. Quantos aqui ouvem, os olhos eram de fé. Quantos elementos movem aquela mulher? Outros homens eram inverno, outros verão.
monótonos caindo secos no solo da minha mão. Gêmeo entre cabeças, pontas do esporão. A folha do não me toque, o medo da solidão. Veneno, meu companheiro, meu cantador. E desemboca no guerreiro mandando do meu amor. É quando o vento sacode a cabeleira, a trança toda vermelha. Sacode a cabeleira, a trança toda vermelha. O vento cego vagueia procurando por um. Quantos elementos amam aquela mulher? Quantos homens eram inverno, outros verão? Gemerão entre cabeças no colo da minha mão. É quando o vento sacode a cabeleira, a trança toda vermelha. Quando o vento sacode a cabeleira, a trança toda vermelha. O vento cego vagueia procurando por um.
Let me find it. Here we go.
This one is a little intense.
It's great. I'm afraid to applaud because I think it might set off the microphone. It was fantastic.
Yeah. Thank you. What
you mentioned was the umbrellas that reminded me of the parasols in New Orleans. They have also little umbrellas, like for the second lines.
Oh, that's really cool. I didn't get to see that.
You see those as well, like at Mardi Gras sometimes. People have those for costumes. And so there's another connection.
It's really nice. I wonder like where it comes from, because it probably, like it's a very specific thing, like to carry like colored umbrellas and dance with it. So it might have like the same origin.
Cool.
Right. Yeah.
So I see in the chat, like everybody thanks you. Like this has been terrific. Ha sido un placer immenso. Thanks also to Naira y Lau. It was great to meet you on Zoom, on the computer screen.
Foi ótimo conhecer vocês pelo Zoom. Que foi um prazer, foi muito bom. Immeasurable.
Pleasure for me to be with you. She is my pride and joy. When she was young, she studied with me, and I see very much talent in the first time. And she improved day by day. It's very grateful. I'm very happy to see when we
with you.
And improve and studying for a professional
career.
We're very happy to have Giulia in New Orleans at Loyola, and we hope when the pandemic is over, you're back in New Orleans, we'll have more Brazilian music on campus.
Hopefully, yes. Maybe someday when they come, we can play all together for you live.
Oh, we would love that, and then we don't have to worry about microphones or at least not about the internet.
Exactly, or COVID.
Yes, or COVID. Ha sido um prazer imenso. Encantado. And I'll share my screen for a little bit to show our email address. So if any of our guests, if you have questions, suggestions, you want to know the song list, then just send us an email at cie@loino.edu. And then we can put you in touch with Giulia, and she can answer more questions also and give you the composers and the song names. A big thank you also to Alexis, who has set up the Zoom and had admitted people into the room and also did the sound checks and troubleshooting. Without him, this wouldn't have been possible, like over the internet. I want to thank everyone for joining us. I saw we had two international students from Africa, like Yolanda Timothy, who's from South Africa. I think she must have listened from South Africa today. And then Michin Okoli, who's from Nigeria, and she has arrived for the first time in New Orleans last week. So she listened from campus. And it was a huge pleasure. And it was great to see you. And we can't wait to have you back on campus, Giulia.
Thank you so much. It was an immense pleasure to be here. And I'm just really happy that happened. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you, Al and Naida, who agreed to do this with me. And it's really nice. Thank you so much.
And Lau, thank you for doing the short notice, like that, joining.
Thank you. And thank you too for the opportunity. Right.
Obrigadinho. And have a great carnival. Have a happy Mardi Gras, as we say in New Orleans.
Nice. Happy Mardi Gras for you all.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thank you, Naida. Thank you, Lau.
Thank you.
Ciao. Até já.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ciao.
Queria ler os comentários.